Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel, The Perspective. Today, as part of Ladakh series, we will be looking at strategic importance of the Chushul sector. In the intervening night of 29th and 30th August and subsequently on intervening night of 30th and 31st August, Indian Army took a series of actions under which it established control of the ridge lines on either side of Spangur Gap. The commentary on this development has so far focused on the tactical aspect of this exercise. Events are being seen with respect to the immediate area of southern bank of Pengongso Lake and Spangur So. In this analysis, we will see how Indian Army's choice of taking proactive measure in the Chushul sector has a larger strategic significance. In part 2, which will follow later, we will also look at this development in terms of its impact on the immediate Pengongso and Chushul sector. Let's come to the geographical sighting of Chushul sector, because as we will see, the location of Chushul sector is very critical to defense of eastern Ladakh. To start with, we have a satellite image in front of us, which covers most of eastern Ladakh. The outer red line that you see is the historic Ladakh and Tibet boundary. This is the maximum claim that we have in the eastern Ladakh sector. Then we have the inner red line is the Chinese claim line. Now we agree to this claim line at certain places. We do not agree to this claim line at other places. At some places, like we saw in case of Finger 4 and Finger 8, there is a difference of perception where India also has its own claim line. Chushul is located on the banks of Pengongso Lake. Then we come to Leh, which is the capital of the Union Territory of Ladakh. It is a major political, military and economic center and the location of only major airport in Ladakh theater. This makes it the center of gravity for the entire Ladakh theater actually. Then we have Darbuk. This is the starting point of the newly commissioned Darbuk-Shayok DBO road. To their east is Lukung and Phovrang. These are located on the northern bank of Pengongso Lake. These are actually two separate localities, but they are located very close to each other. So in this map, they have been marked as one. Now, these are important nodes because the roads which emanate towards Gogra, Anila Pass and Finger area, they start from either Lukung or Phovrang. Then we have Nayoma, located along the Indus River on the road towards Leh. Close to Nayoma, the road bifurcates and goes towards the Chumur sector. Chumur again is one of the major flashpoints between India and China and eastern Ladakh. In September 2014, only a few months after the Narendra Modi government had taken charge, there was a major confrontation between Indian and the Chinese troops, which continued for a few weeks. Dumti is located to southeast of Chushul, and this is again a major landmark because the Indus River, which enters India from Tibet, takes a sharp bend at Dumti towards west and then curves north towards Leh. Dimchok again sits very close to the historic India, Ladakh and Tibet boundary. Dimchok is again a major flashpoint where there is a difference in perception of LAC. The Chinese had come till a certain point in 1962, and over the years, this is one sector where they have nibbled a lot of territory through their creeping and salami slicing tactics. Now, Now, what we have in front of you is the terrain map of this sector, which highlights the major physical or geographical features. To start with, this is the Indus River. It enters Leh, Ladakh from Tibet, somewhere south here at Dhemchok. At Dungti, it takes a sharp bend and then moves to along a gorge towards Leh. The only road that connects Leh with the southeastern part and the southern part of Ladakh moves along the Indus Gorge. After this, you have the Ladakh Range. Now, Ladakh Range starts at a point close to confluence of Indus and Shyok River in northern areas of Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, and it runs till Dungti. The length of this range is about 370 kilometers with average height in excess of 18,000 feet. Now, Ladakh Range, it presents a major physical barrier from military perspective as it limits the lateral movement from west to east or east to west. Any movement has to happen along a few high altitude mountain passes in Ladakh Range. So, for example, if you want to go towards Nubra and Shyok Valley or Siachen from Leh, you have to cross the Khardungla Pass. Similarly, if you have to move towards Darbuk, Lukung or Pangongso Lakes, then you have to cross the Changla Pass. It is about 17,590 feet. And this is the only major pass. After Changla Pass, there is one more minor pass over here. And then there is no pass in between. So again, your option is, if you want to go from east to west or west to east, your only option is either you cross this high altitude pass, which has a very steep gradient, or you move along the Indus River and then, go towards Chushul or, other locations. Third important physical feature here is your Pengong Range. This Pengong Range runs parallel to the Pengongso Lake on its western bank. Average height is 19,000 feet and there are no passes to permit any east-west connectivity. So you cannot go from this side to this side. This is not possible. And then we have the Kailash Range, which is in news nowadays. The Kailash Range starts from approximately the middle section of southern side of Pengongso Range, and it runs till almost the Lake Mansarovar. The holy Mount Kailash is located within the Kailash Range, and all the important features that are in news nowadays, including your Rezangla, Richenla, Mukhupari, are located on a ridgeline which form part of the initial part of the Kailash Range. Road connectivity. This is an all important topic when it comes to mountain areas, because ultimately the physical features decide how you can go from place A to place B, which has a serious impact in terms of your military options. So here we have a satellite map which shows location of Chushul and other important landmarks in the area. You can easily make out Ladakh Range, which is massive and serves as a great barrier. And then you have the Pengong Range, which serves as which runs parallel to the western shore of Pengongso Lake. Looking at this map, you can appreciate how massive the Ladakh Range is, what kind of a formidable geographical entity it is, and the kind of challenge that it poses to connectivity and subsequently to military operations. Coming to the road connectivity, this is the first road that moves along the Indus alignment. The distance is 266 kilometers. It starts at Leh and then comes towards at Neoma, where it branches and moves in a southwesterly direction towards Chumur. Then it comes to Loma, and then from here again it diverts, it bifurcates towards Ugdungle, towards south southern Ladakh, and another road goes towards Demchok. From Loma, the road curves in a northerly direction and moves towards Chushul. You know, an important thing to notice here is that how close this road runs to the Spangur Gap and the Chinese claim line passing through the Kailash Range. The proximity of the road to the Chinese claim line has both strategic and tactical implications. We will explore on this subject later. Then we have second road, which is has a distance of about 201 kilometers. Again, starts from Leh, crosses the 17,590 feet high Changla Pass, comes down to Tangse and moves to Chushul. From Tangse onward, it moves along a river valley between Ladakh Range towards west and Bangongso Range towards east. So this you can make out, this is your Ladakh Range and this is your Pangongso Range, and between this you have this gorge along which or a river valley along which this road comes. And while in terms of distance, the direct Leh Chushul road is longer, but in terms of travel time, it has lesser travel time, primarily because you are moving along a plain surface compared to coming through the Changla Pass, where you have to navigate a very steep pass. Now we come to the all important topic of strategic importance of the Chushul sector. So given the central location of Chushul, any breakthrough by the Chinese in this sector has the potential to threaten Indian troops and subsectors towards north and south. As we shall see, Chushul is actually the linchpin, and any Indian loss here has the potential of far-reaching consequences. First, let us look at the impact of Chushul sector on subsectors located towards its north. On this satellite map, you can make out location of Chushul with respect to Spangur Gap and few other important geographical features on Kailash Range. You can also make out the road coming to Chushul between Pengong Range and the massive Ladakh Range. Now let us see the strategic importance of Spangur Gap. If the Chinese were to break out of Spangur Gap, then technically they can mount an attack on Tangse along the Chushul-Tangse road. And Tangse is a very important node because just north of Tangse is Darbuk, which is the starting point of new Darbuk-Shayok-DBO road. Not to forget that the road coming from Leh across Changla Pass lands close to Darbuk. It is also a point from where road bifurcates towards northern bank of Pangongso, including Lukung and Phovrang. Lukung and Phovrang by themselves are very critical from the perspective of the defense of Chang Chenmo, Chushul and Pangongso sector. And here's why. Because the road network towards the entire Chang Chenmo sector, where you have the hot springs and Gogura post, starts from Lukung. Secondly, the roads towards the strategically very important Anila Pass and the entire northern bank of Pangongso Lake till Finger 4 also starts from Phovrang. So, if the Chinese were to take Tangse, they can achieve multiple objectives. First, they can block access to the DBO road. Second, with there is an additional possibility, then they can spill over into the Shayok Valley and move north along the DBO road and attack Indian positions in DBO sector from rear, or they can go in the westerly direction along the Shayok River and threaten the Nubra Valley and the Siachen sector. From Darbuk, they can also mount an attack towards Leh by crossing the Changla Pass. Or they can move in an easterly direction and attack Lukung and Phobran. Now, as we have seen, if Lukung was to fall, then the entire Indian garrison in Chang Chenmo River Valley, which is your Hot Springs and Gogra, will become isolated. Similarly, we will also end up losing all the territory along the northern bank of Pengongso Lake. So, another option which the Chinese also have is to move along the bank of the Pengongso Lake. Even though the road network here isn't too great, but this is also an axis which they can explore and move towards Lukung. So, as you can make out from this analysis, that it is very important for them, the Chinese perspective, to control this Pangur Gap and break out from here, because it gives them the option to threaten the rear section of Indian defenses in the northern belt of eastern Ladakh. We saw the potential impact of Chinese breakout from this Pangur Gap towards north. Now let us look at the impact it can have towards major sectors located to south of Chushul. To begin with, the Chinese can move south along Dungti to reach Demchok, traveling along the Indian roads in the sector, and this way they can attack the Indian troops located in Demchok from rear. Now, combined with any attack that would be happening from Tibet side towards Demchok, Indian troops will be caught in a pincer. Another thing that the Chinese can do and will definitely do if they were to break out is to turn west and take Loma. If they take Loma, what they do is they will not only block any access to Dungti and Demchok sector, but will also be in position to launch an offensive towards the Ugdunle sector. Moving from Loma, the Chinese can move further west and take Neoma. And from Neoma, they can develop an attack on the Chumur sector, again traveling along Indian roads. So basically, what you see over here is that a Chinese breakout from Spangur Gap and moving southward has the potential to not only isolate all the Indian sectors from their major hub in Leh, but it also has the potential to attack these sectors from rear, thereby catching Indian troops in a pincer. And if this was to happen, then India will end up losing a lot of critical territory. Okay, now moving forward from Neoma, the Chinese can develop attack along the only road that goes towards Leh and which moves along the Indus River alignment. If this was to happen, then the Chinese will be in a position to threaten the most important economic and military objective in the entire Ladakh sector, and basically compromise our position in this entire area. So, long story short, any major breakthrough from Chushul sector can have serious repercussions for the entire eastern Ladakh sector. It is very vital from the perspective of overall defense of eastern Ladakh. So a decision taken by the Indian Army to readjust the placement of troops and their alignment and take this ridge line should be seen in this overall strategic perspective. It is not a tactical operation to be seen with respect only to Pangongso sector or the Chushul sector. As we have seen, it has a much, much wider strategic implication. And this also tells you why the Chinese are so agitated, because they have lost a major initiative. And as we will see in a subsequent slide, what has also happened is that by losing the initiative, Chinese are now in a big fix with respect to their position in this Pangongso sector. Chinese bottleneck. When we say Chinese bottleneck, what I basically mean is this. Now, what you have in front of you is a satellite map which shows the location of Chushul and Rutong. And as you can see, there is a road that comes from Rutong towards Pangongso and Chushul sector, which is about 110 kilometers long. Now, what is apparent from this satellite image is the fact that this road or this approach from Rutong to Chushul is like a funnel. It's a 110 kilometer long funnel. Why it is a funnel is because if you see on either side of this flat terrain are two very high mountain ridges, in excess of 17,000 feet. And my research has shown that there are no passes which go from this funnel either to east or to west. So basically, the only option that any Chinese troops in this area has is to come along this funnel towards the Chushul sector. They cannot move towards east, they cannot move towards west. They are stuck in this funnel. Now, this funnel is 4 kilometer at its widest. At other places, it is much lesser in width than that. Apart from that, there are multiple choke points along the way. So even if the Chinese were to bring in large number of tanks, infantry fighting vehicles, artillery, infantry, they are stuck within this funnel. For any Chinese force to be useful, they have to break out of this Pangor Gap and take the Chushul Bowl, or the Chinese forces run the risk of getting trapped within this funnel. So this is how you need to see this entire development. A, from the perspective of Chinese breaking out of Pangor Gap and its impact on all the other subsector towards north and south of Chushul, and its impact on the Chinese. Now, by taking the ridge line, what the Indian Army has done is Indian Army has boxed the entire Chinese military presence within this funnel. And while you can park your troops in the side valleys, which come from these mountain ridges towards this funnel, there is not much you can do apart from that. They cannot move. And any Chinese force coming along this funnel is liable to be interdicted either through air to ground attack or through artillery attack. This is a terrain map which shows a similar thing, but and you can clearly make out the flat space between the two mountain ridges on either side. And like I said, the this particular ridge, this sorry, this particular funnel lacks width. It is less than 4 kilometer at its maximum. Second, there are multiple choke points, which you can see on the map. These are just some of the choke points that I have been able to identify. Now, for example, the road that is coming from Rutong towards Pangor runs along the shoreline of two lakes. One is this Pangorso itself towards the Chushul sector, and other is this smaller lake that you can make out over here. Now, what that does is the ridge lines, as you can see, these ridge lines they run practically to the edge of the lake. They're coming right up to the bank of the lake. So, because of which, the road that runs along the shoreline of this the of the of this Pangorso Lake does not have much of a width, so the vehicles have to come in a single line, and this creates a bottleneck. Now we saw something similar in the Pangongso sector. If you remember, there was a video which was circulated where you had Indian troops having a go at Chinese a clone of Humvee vehicles, and while the Chinese column was pretty large, they were all arranged in a single file. They were all arranged in a linear fashion because there was just no place for the vehicle in the rear to come forward. So similar is the case here. I mean, for the Chinese, they do not have much real estate to park their troops. We see a similar thing here. This is the gorge which is close to Rutok, when the road starts from Rutok towards Chushul. And you can see the gap here is less than 1 kilometer. Here again is the another lake which is close to Rutok, and the width of the road here is less than 1 kilometer. The area over here is less than 1 kilometer, and this is a stretch of almost 2 kilometers. So if you see from the Chinese perspective, Chinese have to come out of this particular funnel onto the Chushul ball. Now let's come to importance of the ridge line. Now this is the ridge line which now almost everybody is familiar with. Blue colored features are under Indian control, while red colored ones are with China. I know there is a lot of confusion with respect to who holds the black top, but for this analysis I will proceed with the assumption that it is still with Chinese. Spangur gap is prominently visible. Now the reason it is marked in blue, to signify that it is in Indian control, is because with the Indian army holding the high points along both its shoulders, no Chinese movement is possible along this gap. Now we also know that Chinese must break out from Spangur gap and move towards north and south as shown on the map. See, this is what the Chinese need to do. Now for this to be possible, Chinese have to do two things. First, control the entire Kailash ridgeline in this sector from bank of Pangongso Lake to Rechinla. And second, it needs to mount an assault to physically control the Chushul bowl. What the Chinese army can do, had they taken this ridgeline, is that they can dominate all Indian positions and posts in the Chushul sector. They can interdict all our movement and target Indian troops and assets. And finally, when push comes to shove, the Chinese can come down from these ridge lines and occupy the Chushul bowl. However, what we have done is we have done something completely opposite. We have now taken the ridge line, and by taking the ridge line, we have ensured that none of these expansions by the Chinese army are possible. They cannot come down from the ridge line, they cannot exploit the Spangur gap, and they cannot threaten the Chushul bowl. On the contrary, the Indian troops sitting on these ridge lines can move down from these ridge lines and completely occupy the entire Spangurso sector. See, so you can dominate all these ridge lines and take the sector and eliminate the Chinese presence in this area. So in conclusion, the Indian act of taking a ridge line along Kailash range in the Chushul sector has much larger ramification. In my opinion, this was a deliberate decision which was meant to remove an important threat to our defenses in the eastern Ladakh sector. Yes, it has additional impact on the Chinese ability to hold the Spangurso sector and adjoining Pangongso sector, which we will see later. But that is a subject of a much larger objective which has been achieved. And finally, by taking the ridge line, India has literally bottled thousands of Chinese troops and their tanks and infantry fighting vehicles in the Spangurso sector. Thank you for watching. If you like, please do subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon and wait for further updates. Thank you very much. Have a great day. Thank you.